good evening, good morning, good whatever time of day it is when you watch this. My name is Birgit, and today we'll go through a few poses to loosen up your back a bit, to get your hips and your hip flexors a little bit more loose, and to work on your posture. So that doesn't require any prior knowledge, so just roll with me and listen really well to what is happening in your body. So the more present you become in your body as we're going through these movements and poses, the more benefit you will take away from it, because you don't only copy what you see from me, but you also realize, oh, those are the muscles I'm using right now. Okay, so if I want to get to this place, this is what I have to engage. And that's what we want to focus on for today. So first, let's take a few more breaths to just get really present here. Deep inhale through your nose. Exhale, let everything out with a sigh. Good, another deep inhale. Exhale with a sigh. Third one's a charm, inhale. To a pose that I really like to get started with in our practice, and that's cat-cow. So for that, with an inhale, you let your belly sink down, reach your heart forward, lift your gaze a little bit. This is cow pose. And then with the exhale, pull your navel towards your spine and round your back like a cat. Inhale, belly sinks down, reach your heart forward. Exhale, round your back as much as you can. Pull those shoulders up to the front. Tuck your tailbone under. Inhale, belly sinks down again. Exhale, round. Inhale, belly sinks down. Heart reaches forward. Exhale, round your back. Two more. Inhale, belly sinks down. Exhale, round. Last one. Inhale, belly sinks down. Exhale, round. With your next inhale, come back to neutral back position. And then with the exhale, lift your right hand forward as if you were going to shake somebody's hand. If this is plenty of back engagement, you just stay right here and your gaze goes slightly in front of you towards the floor. If you would like a little more, you can also lift that left leg and balance here. And then with every inhale, you want to reach out those right fingertips and reach the left heel more towards the back. So reach those away from each other as far as you can and engage your lower abs. One more inhale here. Exhale, bring them back down. Inhale, your left hand forward. Let's do the other side. And with the exhale, if you like, you can also lift that leg. And then with every inhale, reach those fingertips and the heel further away from each other. Make sure your belly is still engaged, and you probably can feel all your back muscles. And that's exactly what we're doing this for. Last inhale here. Exhale, bring them back down. From here, just circle your hips a little bit. See if we can get some movement in here, one direction. And then in the other direction. And then walk your hands forward, and I have a pillow here, so you can make use of a pillow if you like. See where you can get. So one way of doing this is you just bring your elbows to the floor and then relax your head. And maybe that doesn't reach the floor, so in that case you can use that pillow to relax your head onto it. Or
Maybe you can reach a little further down. This pose is called melting heart pose. And so you want to get your chest as close to the floor as you can. If it gets too intense, you can take your knees wider so that you come down here. Again, if too intense, take that pillow and put it somewhere else so it gets less intense. So knees further apart, pillow underneath, all of those are options.
Forehead down or chin down,
both of those are options. So you figure out what works for you. You want to have your hips over your knees in this pose, and then just let your heart sink towards the floor. If it gets pinchy in the shoulders, bend your elbows a little more. So you find what works best for your body. Two more breaths here. With your next inhale, slowly come back out of the pose. Take that pillow away for now. Bring your knees back to hip width, and then we'll tuck the toes, and we'll just lift those knees about 2 inches off the mat, or 5 centimeters. Then we'll hold it here, and then with your inhale, pull your head towards the front of the mat and pull your tailbone towards the back. We're engaging our core and making sure all those muscles get warmed up and awakened. One more breath here. Exhale, bring them back down. Inhale, sit up, sit back onto your heels, and you're gonna feel a stretch in those toes pretty soon. If it gets too intense, you can always lean forward. If it's doable, try to sit up straight here, and it's going to open up the bottoms of your feet that most of the day hang out stuck in shoes, so it might be nice to give them a little space. And after about 20 seconds at the latest, pretty much everybody feels like the toes are going to fall off. I promise you they're not going to fall off. So see if you can relax a little bit into it and just breathe. Two more breaths here. Good work. Exhale, come forward, take the weight out. Double check whether all your toes are still there. Good. And then from here, we'll come into downward facing dog. So you'll tuck those toes again, but this time we'll take the knees further off the mat. We'll come into a shape that's like an upside down triangle. You want to try and press your fingers into the mat as good as you can. And this is where my makeshift mat that consists of a folded blanket is not as great because it starts stretching and sliding. So maybe you just want to do this on the floor without anything underneath if you don't have a yoga mat. And what you want to focus on is to get a good stretch in the back side of your legs. Depending on how your body is built, you may experience a lot of tension in the back side of your legs, in which case you can bend your knees a bit. You may also experience some tension in your lower back if that is your tightest spot. And then you can just take your feet a little wider to give that some more space. So you make it work for you. And then try to relax your neck and pull the shoulders away from each other so you have a lot of space in between the shoulder blades. Two more breaths here. Exhale, come back down. Nice. From here, we're going to inhale the right leg forward, and we'll come into a low lunge. Low lunge means that your back knee stays on the floor. You can come up onto your fingertips here, and if your hands don't quite reach the floor, you can always put some thick books or blocks underneath your hands here and press down on those.
you can release that left hip crease a little more. One more inhale here. Exhale, shift your weight back and see how far you can straighten that front leg. Again, maybe you need blocks underneath here so you don't wiggle too much from left to right. And that is perfectly fine. You want to feel a stretch in the backside of this leg, so you want to pull those toes back towards your face. Last inhale here. And with your exhale, shift your weight back forward. We'll come back into that low lunge. See if you can note a slight difference. Maybe you can come a little bit lower this time. Not by trying hard, just by softening. One more deep breath here. And then with an exhale, bring that leg back. And with your inhale, we're bringing the other leg forward. So left leg comes forward. Again, hands on blocks or on your fingertips. Right knee is on the floor. Your left ankle is right underneath your knee. That's the most stable position for the knee. That way it stays happy. If your knee down here is really sensitive, you can always put a little bit more cushioning underneath it. And then with every exhale, soften that right hip crease. Let it go a little more. Two more breaths here. Your next inhale, shift your weight back, pull your front toes back towards your face on the fingertips or on your blocks. By the way, your blocks do not have to be yoga blocks. They can be rolls of toilet paper, they can be rolled blankets, they can be towels, they can be books. I've used a ton of different things. Last breath here. And with your exhale, shift your weight back forward. Hold it here for a second time. See if you can notice a difference to when you were up here for the first time. Notice also if you notice a difference in comparison with the other side. Because a lot of the time our sides, I call it, there's a fun side. That's the side that's a little more resistant. So we'll just keep working with that, and over time it's going to soften too. Last breath here. Exhale, bring the second leg back as well. We'll sit back onto our heels and bring the forehead to the floor if that is available to you. If it's not, bring it down on a pillow. Or you can bring it down on your folded hands if that is available. And if the floor is easily in reach, then you can choose to bring your hands back beside your body. Anywhere works. What we want to do is give a lot of space to all of your spine and let your hips sink as close as they can towards your heels. One more deep breath here. Exhale, slowly roll back up. Okay. From here, we'll come up onto our knees and we're going to open up the heart space a little more. Remember, the first one was when we were laying down, opening that heart space, and the second one, we're going to put our hands onto our lower back. backs onto the hips, fingers are pointing downward, and then you press your hips forward and reach your heart up. And what this is good for is it opens up your entire chest part here, because a lot of the time we sit hunched over a laptop or whatever we're working on, and so this is a good counter pose. And with every inhale, just focus on reaching that heart a little bit higher. Last inhale here. Exhale, come back to center, sit back down onto your heels. So far, so good. I just got a couple more for you. So we're going to lay back down on our bellies. And from here, we're going to... You know that sound effect. We're going to first just lift up our arms and keep our legs on the floor, and then we'll do the other way around. So inhale, lift your arms. And your neck is an extension of your spine, so don't look up too far, rather down towards the floor in front of you. So this engages all your upper and middle back muscles, and the lower ones potentially as well. One more inhale here. Exhale, fold your hands and lay your cheek down. Gently wiggle your hips from left to right. And then we'll float up the legs with the next inhale. This time your upper body stays on the floor. Inhale your legs up. Keep your knees as straight as possible here. So this time there's more focus on the lower back muscles, lower and middle back. One more deep inhale here. Exhale back down. Gently wiggle those hips. And for round number three, because all good things are three, said some fairy tale authors, we're going to lift up the arms and the legs. So inhale up everything. Give it two more deep breaths here. Lift it a little higher. Exhale, bring everything back down. Good, wiggle it out. And from here, just roll over onto your back. Take that right knee and pull it into your chest. And then with the exhale, take your left hand onto that right knee and gently bring it over to the side while your shoulders stay on the floor. So that knee is probably going to be hanging out somewhere midair, and your shoulders are still both on the floor. And this is to get a lot of twist in your spine. So you want to look over your right shoulder. So I'm going to look to the back wall here so that you're twisted from the very top of your spine to the very bottom of your spine. And then with every breath, see where you can let go a little bit and release. One more breath here. And with your next inhale, come back to center. And with the exhale, swap the legs. So left knee pulls into the chest. And then with the exhale, bring the right hand on top of that left knee. And get that knee over to the right side while your shoulders stay on the floor. let your gaze follow that left arm. So your twist goes all the way from the top of your spine to the bottom. Give it two more deep breaths here. See where you can still soften. Your next inhale, pull your knees back into your chest. And gently move those knees around. Give yourself a lower back massage. And then bring the soles of your feet onto the mat or wherever you're laying on and walk them out towards the side. So we're now further than hip width apart. And then let your knees fall together. So depending on how much space you have, you either don't have to walk them very far apart and you can already feel that you're at the edge of what is in reach for you, or you may have to walk them out a little further if you're not feeling any stretch. So you're going to feel this in the outside of your hips and potentially into your lower back, but only here on the side. If it feels painful in your lower back, then back off, then you're trying to do too much. So you got to find the right level of the slight discomfort, not pain. And this is a really nice stretch on the hips. So we're just going to hang out here for a little bit. And you can rest your arms by your side. Have your gaze follow the tip of your nose and then just close your eyes here for a moment. Take a deep inhale, exhale, release, another deep inhale, exhale, release, last inhale, exhale, release. Gently come out of that pose. And we'll do one last one that I really love, and it's called Happy Baby. So you have a couple of options here. Ideally, you want the soles of your feet reaching up towards the ceiling, and then bend your knees a lot, because we want to pull our knees down. And then, depending on where you can reach, you can either grab your shins here, or maybe your ankles, and just hang here. So what I sometimes see is that people have their feet very close together and then it's harder. So make sure your feet are wider than your hips here. And then whatever you can reach. And then you pull down. And if you can reach the soles of your feet, perfect. And if you can reach the inside instead of the outside, perfect. Whatever you can reach to hold on to and to pull down, that is good. And you want to make sure that your tailbone is pulling down towards the mat. So it's not about rolling up here. It's about getting everything down towards the mat. The most important part about a happy baby is you pull the corners of your mouth back towards your ears. Oh, like that. And then if you feel like you want to get a few wiggles out, I always think that feels nice. Two more breaths here. And then exhale, let everything release down onto the mat. If you have lower back trouble, when you are in your final resting pose in Shavasana, it can be nice to have a pillow underneath your knees. That's going to relieve your lower back here. So if that's something you have going on, you know what to do. And this final resting pose here is really important. It's for integrating everything
that you just went through, so that your body can really soak it up and create a memory of it in the sense of, oh, this is how good this can feel. All right, let's memorize that. Let's make sure we can remember how to get to this place. Which muscles to engage, which muscles to release, where to put my attention, where to focus my energy, and being really present with my breath. One more inhale here. Exhale, slowly come back. Blink your eyes open. Wiggle your hands and your feet. And then roll over onto your side. Stay here for a moment and notice how you cared for. And then with another inhale, press yourself back up into a seated position. And I thank you for letting me guide you through this practice. Hope to see you soon.